Hei, og velkommen til Britt Arnhilds advent den 10. desember. I dag tenkte jeg skulle ta dere med tilbake til 2003. Det var nemlig det første året jeg på en måte startet å blogge om advent. Nå var det før jeg hadde oppdaget blogging. Jeg vet ikke om blogging var oppfunnet en gang. Da, mulig at det var det. To år senere, i 2005, så hadde jeg fått min første blogg, og kunne blogge med bilder og det å legge ut på en plattform hver dag I advent. Men I 2003 så var det e-post som gjaldt, og hver dag I advent det året, og I 2004, så sendte jeg ut en e-post på engelsk til venner som jeg hadde rundt omkring I hele verden. Og jeg tenkte jeg skulle lese den e-posten her I dag. Hello and welcome to Britt Arnhilds Advent. Today I have a little English surprise. I know that I have English followers and several of you are asking for some English speaking in my Advent vlog. Today I plan to read for you. The first email I sent out in December 2003, it was before I started my first blog, actually 2 years before, two Advents before. So what I did that year was that I made one email every single day during Advent from the first Sunday of Advent, or actually from the day before the first Sunday of Advent. And sent out to friends over the whole world. I'm going to read this email for you today in English. But first I need some hot tea. It's morning and my voice is a little groggy. I'm sorry. November 29th, 2003. Dear friends, I have been looking forward to this weekend for a long time. It is the weekend to start Advent preparations, and over the years this has become more and more important for me. It is still almost 4 weeks till Christmas, and this period will be the period for preparations. Preparations to open my mind for the wonder which happened 2,000 years ago and happens again every year. The Creator became man and came to this world. The Advent color is purple, lilac. And our decorations the coming weeks will mostly have this color, though all through our house more and more Christmas decorations will be seen. Tomorrow is the first Sunday of Advent, and already tonight a star will be hung in our living room window, and Advent wreaths with four candles will be set all through the house. Tomorrow the first candle will be lit, then one more for each day, for each of the coming 4 Sundays. Sorry. I have the Advent calendars ready for the girls, one basket for each with 24 packets in. It was a great pleasure last night to wrap them all, as it has been a pleasure the last weeks to use my creativity to gather gifts for them. It is an aim for me that the gifts shall not be expensive, use and throw away gifts, but small tokens they will like and use. The huge working table here in my studio is filled with boxes of what I call my very own advent calendar. A huge box with all my Christmas books, a smaller one with CDs, a basket with my snowman collection, another with my angels. Several colorful baskets with small and bigger quilts in progress. My snow globe collection is here, and also my homemade Christmas stockings. And not to forget my nativity scenes. I have 4 scenes so far, and they are all very special to me. One is from Haiti, bought when I visited the country in 1998. It is a coconut with an opening for the door, and the figurines are made out of clay and painted in bright colors. I also want to mention our newest scene, bought in Provence this summer, traditional provincial sentence. Well, just like a child, and at Christmas time, it is important that we all behave like children. I cannot wait till Monday and December 1st. The first Christmas CD, Christmas in Vienna 3, with Placido Domingo, Charles Aznavour, and our own Cécile Kyrkjebø, is on the CD player. My Debbie Mam, The Magic of Santa mug, is filled with spiced tea. And as soon as this letter is finished, I have Mary Engelbreit's Christmas Companion waiting to be enjoyed. Happy Advent, and remember to take time to enjoy this very special period of the year. Det var det aller første adventskurv, Advent Basket, brevet som sendt ut. Advent 2003. Siden det 10. I dag, så tenkte jeg det kunne være litt morsomt å lese det brevet som sendt ut 10. desember også. 10. desember 2003, så her kommer det. Jeg beklager at engelsken min kan bli litt sånn krøll på tunga av og til, men jeg håper det går bra, og håper at dere norske lesere også skjønner det. I'm sorry that my English is a bit curls on the tongue, as we say in Norway, from time to time. But I hope you understand the meaning. December 10th, 2003. Dear friends, again we are watching handball here. The World Championship is going on in Croatia, I think it is. And tonight Norway is playing against Hungary. And right now there is an extra break because the sport arena where they are playing lost its electricity. And everything is totally chaotic. Well, I'm using the break to write my daily letter. Many of you have asked about my Advent basket. What is this actually? So I will give an explanation. First of all, I must say that this is not a Norwegian tradition. It is totally my own. We always have Advent calendars here. I remember when I was a child, my mother made them for us. 24 small matchboxes draped in bright papers and with a piece of chocolate hidden in each box. Or other years, it could be a cardboard picture with doors to open and just small drawings to look at each day. For our kids, we have had a lot of different calendars, but the most recent years, we have wrapped 24 small gifts for them. I had a quilt where I hang the gifts, but as some of them was too big, I started to use a basket. Our two girls have one basket each this year. Then, some years ago, I got the idea to have a basket for myself. But instead of buying new items for it, I wanted to use things from my collections and use them to start decorating. Traditionally, we don't decorate until December 23rd in Norway. But after I started this basket, this has changed in our home. The main decorating will still be the 23rd, but from December 1st, our house more and more transform to a Christmassy, enchanted place. In my basket, I put from my collections an angel, a snowman, a quilt, a book, a stocking, a magazine, a snow globe, and a CD. Did I remember everything? Well, at least the first days, it contains all this. I don't have 24 of all this, so as the days go by, the contents will change a little. I hope this explains my basket idea. I myself fill the basket every evening, and I myself take out the contents every morning and use it for decorations, play the CD, look through the magazine, and so on. My 7 years old Marta also loves this, of course, and is a very good helper. I have been home from work today. Have worked so much this fall and has taken today and tomorrow off. Has planned a lot of housework, but instead I have spent the day totally relaxing. I have written a lot of Christmas cards, read a lot, knitted a lot, made a nice dinner for the six of us, and really enjoyed myself. I have already hung all the 5 Christmas stockings I have in my collection, but today there was red and grey yarn to start another stocking in the basket, which I did tonight. I had an enjoyable moment when the mailman came around noon. The mailbox is always filled at this time of the year. Oh, I so much love staying in contact with friends worldwide through mail. Cannot tell about all the mail I got, but want to mention one packet especially. It was from Donna, which also gets this letter, and together with a letter and small gifts for me and the girls, which will be put in our stockings for Christmas morning, there were a beautiful angel and an envelope with vintage postcards. Oh, I love them. I will display them on the shelf I have for vintage writing equipment. There is a postcard from Senegal, posted back in 1964, written by some missionaries, I think, and they tell that they met Dr. Schweitzer, written very, very strange. Isn't that amazing? Albert Schweitzer, of course. There are also several unused postcards from the 20s and 30s. I love to get mail like this. Well, this is long enough for you to read today, I think. More to come tomorrow. Britt Arnhilds.